can't believe Hades was behind the entire underworld invasion.
And he created Medusa to distract everyone.
What do you think Hades is really after?
Something big. He hasn't just overstepped his realm. He's kicked down the door. What I do know is that underworld forces have assembled at a volcano nearby. And that's where today's mission is taking us.
Just put it all together. The underworld army is here to steal magma.
No, Pit. Hades wants the wish seed.
Oh, of course.
From what I've heard, it grants any single wish. As you might imagine, it's quite sought after.
I could really use one of those. My wish would be to fly by myself.
Yes, yes, I'm well aware of that. Anyway...
Don't chase the subject.
The underworld forces seem to be very interested in the wish seed.
Who knows what Hades would wish for if he got it? It could be a total disaster!
I couldn't agree more. Let's hurry, Pit. If Hades has entered the game, he's playing to win.
Plus, if anyone deserves a wish, it's me!
Get ready to go into that cave.
In there. The magma level's rising.
Hopefully it won't rise too fast.
Whoa! Whoa! easy, will you?
The Underworld Army has already reached the Phoenix. They're facing severe resistance.
The Phoenix sounds pretty tough. So if we want the Wish Seed too...
That's right, you'll have to defeat the Phoenix.
I was afraid you'd say that.
Don't worry, he's the Phoenix. He'll come back to life.
That's not exactly what I'm worried about. What I mean to say is... I'm not scared. I'm not scared at all.
Saying it twice doesn't make it more convincing.
How about if I say it a third time? I'm not scared at all.
Well, hello there. Glad to see you made it.
Hades!
Settle down there, Pity. Ladies don't like high-strung fellows. So the good guys covet the wish scene, too. Tell me, goddess, what do you wish for? Is it all kittens and rainbows, or is it something more interesting?
I'll tell you mine if you tell me yours.
Thanks so much for asking. I just have one humble. You see this poor child? Both of her parents are dead. Aww. There was an unfortunate accident. If you knew what I mean.
You mean you murdered them?
It was a simple case of distracted chariot driving. Should have been doing my hair. Anyway, I was hoping to use the wish seed to bring back the parents. Can you think of anything more joyous than a family reunion? Then after that, they'd strike it rich, like rolling in dough, rich. And then, we'd slap crowns on all of them and make them royalty. And that's the general gist of my wish. Pretty noble, and not at all evil, right? I can't think of anyone more deserving of the wish seed than yours truly.
Let me get this straight. You, the Lord of the Underworld, want to revive the dead. That's somewhat at odds with your mission statement, wouldn't you say?
Don't tell me the goddess of light hasn't heard of altruism before.
What a load of baloney.
My intentions are pure. As Lord of the Underworld, you have my word.
That just makes me more suspicious.
How cold of you. Your words pierce my heart like an icicle.
Is settled into the lava. I don't think it'll budge.
Well, I wouldn't either if I was soaking in a nice hot bath.
Well, look at that. It's an underworld gutter.
So what's its deal?
It gobbles up friends and foes alike, getting extremely strong in the process.
It eats its friends to get stronger? Jeez, talk about a monster.
And its strength grows with every bite it takes. So if you see one, defeat it quickly.
Who's got two thumbs and loves hot spring. Everyone with two thumbs!
I can hear you.
You never told me your wish, even after I bared my very soul to you.
Right, your wish? I don't buy it. In fact, it makes me doubt this entire story. Answer me this. Does the wish seed even have the power to grant wishes?
You're a sharp one. How'd you guess?
What? Are you serious? The wish seed is a fake?
It's so obvious to me. I mean, the idea of a wish seed is pretty far-fetched. Like that would make anyone more powerful than the gods.
Damn. It's totally gonna be like, I wish for a gazillion wishes. Wait, if the wish seed doesn't work, why is he on the World Army going after it?
To make everyone, us included, believe that it's real.
Can't get anything past old Professor Palutena now, can I? If there's one thing you can predict about humans, it's their greed. It's physically impossible for humans to resist the lure of a wish-granting item.
And since they can't get the wish seed from the Phoenix to see it's a fake, you need them to think that someone has made off with it.
At which point, they'll drive themselves to extinction battling for it. And that's good for my business. An ingenious plan, if I do say so myself.
But the Phoenix himself could wipe out humanity if the Underworld sets him loose.
You're right. We have no choice but to defeat him. We've fallen right into Hades' trap.
Flattery will get you nowhere, my dear. Actually, scratch that. It'll get you a hot date with the Phoenix.
Ciao.
Phoenix won't be happy to see you. You can get across these rocks by jumping.
Okay. I just dash up to the edge to jump, right? Miss me! Thanks!
ahead?
The Phoenix is up ahead.
Go die now.
The wish seed looks real enough. The Phoenix!
He's not going to let you go without a fight.
So I should go ahead and attack him?
You have no choice, unless you want to be flambéed. The Phoenix is cranky after fighting the underworld forces. Who knows what he's capable of? You need to stop him.
Oh, I will!
For you when you get back.
Now everyone will know the wish seed was a fake!
No. That beacon shows the world that the Phoenix has been defeated, which will only make the humans believe that someone has taken the wish seed. Now I'll just give them a little nudge. People of the world, the wish seed has been liberated. This is your chance to fulfill your wildest dreams. All you have to do is conquer anyone in your way.
The people will not be so easily deceived.
I wish that were true, but I foresee major bloodshed. This is all my fault.
Officer Pitt, reporting for duty.
The humans have fallen for Hades' hoax. They're killing themselves over that fantasy.
It looks like entire nations are fighting each other.
The Underworld Army is here to gather souls. Clearly, they expect many casualties. We can't stop a war this big right now. Focus on the Underworld Army.
Things are going exactly as Hades planned.
He spread the rumor about the wish seed. And the humans were gullible enough to believe it.
If only we had a chance to tell them the wish seed was a fake. Now look at them. It's like they've lost their humanity and all they have left is brutality. What's wrong?
I have to pull you back now.
Huh? Whoa! Whoa, what was that?
I shot it, but I do say so myself. Good riddance, humans and scum! The world's better off without you!
That was the goddess of nature. Reedy. Pitt, go check things out.
I'm on it.
So you're the famous Palutena. I hear you've been busy.
And you're Viridi, ruler of the Earth and all living things.
I didn't know I had a fan club.
Why have you done this?
Humans are driven by selfish desire. They think only of themselves. They were killing each other for what? A wish? A fake wish? They stray too far from their intended path. That's where my reset bombs come. To help return Earth to its natural state.
But aren't humans living beings too? Yet you think nothing of exterminating them.
That's rich coming from you. You don't seem to have much of a problem slaughtering underworld forces.
But that's totally different.
We're defending the Earth and Heavens from those who seek their destruction. Let's take a closer look at it.
This is a pretty twisted version of nature.
Humans massacre Earth's creatures, decimate the trees, and exploit the land. They're the twisted ones. They're enemies of life itself. Why do they deserve special treatment?
Because of all creatures, humans are closest to the gods. Gods cannot intervene in mankind's affairs as you have. You have no right.
No right? Humans are trampling over the rights of every other living thing. Should I just sit back and watch as they continue to destroy the Earth? No. I must exterminate them all before it's too late.
There's just no reasoning with her.
I have to admit, she has a valid point. But wiping out humanity is not the answer.
I agree completely. You've given us no choice but to oppose you, Viridi.
Oh, that's brave of you. But the force of nature?
Besides you, all I've got are the Centurions. You know, maybe I should open a boot camp to toughen them up.
Still wouldn't get any muscles like these.
Bunch hanging on like that. Set as many free as you can.
Stubborn?
Oh, I didn't mean it like that.
Maybe what you meant to say was insignificant.
I can still make out buildings in this forest.
There must have been a town here.
Reset bombs won't harm wildlife or natural habitats. Their only purpose is the obliteration of humankind.
Oh, is that all?
Suppose that accounts for all the life in here.
In a few years, this place will be completely covered in green. Flowers will bloom, trees will grow, and the natural food chain will take over. It will be mankind's winter and the beginning of my spring.
Hot spring here.
Wait, There's a little water left.
Soak in every random puddle that crosses your path. What's with you and hot springs?
What's with you and not minding your own business?
The trees.
Calling you a snake would be an insult to snakes. You're a crafty, I'll give you that.
Man, look at the face on this guy.
That's a dinner set. Melee attacks won't hurt him at all with his breath. And when he's green, shooting him won't work. What are you gonna do now?
I guess I'll just melee him when he's green and shoot him when he's red.
But... oh, darn it.
Thanks for the advice. When a jitter thug is green, melee him. When he's red, shoot him. Pit.
Believe me, I know. These things drive smooth.
Plus, they provide protection and firepower. Is that good design or what?
this? A hot spring! A huge hot spring!
It's nature's bathtub. There's a maze up ahead. Try not to get too lost. Viridi's army is called the Forces of Nature. Many of her troops are made of natural resources like wood, dirt, and rocks.
Eco-conscious down to her troops. Everyone's going green these days.
I'm not going green. I've always been green. I use cloth shopping bags. I compost my food scraps. And I separate my recycling into 15 types.
Now this is a goddess who sweats the details.
I could learn a thing or two from her.
I'll just take care of these guys first. Avalanche, huh? What are you? A monster truck?
Pit, huh? What are you? A hole in the ground?
He doesn't talk much, does he?
He's a rock. Last I checked, they're more the strong silent type. Tell you what, I'll do the talking for him.
Avalanche Crush! Wow! Nice moves!
Yes, he's been practicing.
Straight on won't do much damage. Swing around him to attack him from behind. To do this, keep your reticle fixed on him. Get up close and dash left or right.
I'll just check out the play movies for details. Looks like there's a weak spot on his butt.
Thank you.
I'm heading out!
The Underworld Army and the forces of nature are engaged in battle.
What? Why are Hades and Viridi fighting?
Isn't it obvious?
You again.
These brutes have a complete disregard for life. They're even worse than humans!
You're one to talk, little goddess. At least I give the humans you killed peace after me.
We have an opportunity here, Pip. Let's use this chaos to our advantage.
Okay, what's my target?
Viridi is planning to drop another reset bomb in this area.
What? Where exactly?
I'm still not sure.
With Hades' army after them too, the humans don't stand a chance. We have to do something.
Wonderful. But we can't rest yet. Viridi has a reset bomb factory that we need to shut down. Once we deal with it, that'll be the end of these horrid things.
Aye, aye! Your reign of destruction ends here, Viridi.
Watch out, Pip.
Laser beams?
Children, we must protect the reset bomb depot!
It won't work, Viridi. You have a problem with humans. Okay, we get it. But more destruction won't help anything.
Please, this is coming from the flying munitions depot and
destroying evil. It's totally different. Look it up.
We're approaching the reset bomb depot.
It's huge!
I'll look for a place to land. Radius pit. I brought a chairbot for you.
I can't imagine that pile of metal is very fuel efficient.
Actually, it runs on goddess power, which is totally renewable.
Nothing like fighting a pile of mud to make a guy feel tough.
Mud drones are pretty resilient, so you actually do need to be tough to fight them. To completely defeat them, you have to take them down 3 times.
Thank you. Has against Hades. He's destructive and evil. What does Hades have against Reed?
I think you answered your own question. Destruction is fun for him.
Well, 5 points for the squares. It's true. This is just my idea of a good time. Not that these serious ladies know anything about having a good time.
Don't even put Lady Palutena in the same sentence as the goddess of brutality.
It's goddess of nature.
You'd think the Lord of the Underworld would be too busy for mischief-making.
Oh, no. Making mischief is one of my principal responsibilities.
We're approaching the bottom of the fortress.
Everything seems to be made out of natural materials.
Reset bombs must grow like fruit.
Organic fruit.
And when it's ripe, it falls off the vine and just organically destroys everything in its path?
That's not exactly how it goes.
But I'm in the ballpark, aren't I?
Nature dictates that all life must eventually break down. This is just an accelerated version of that process.
Enemy.
It's called a meba, and it's actually a kind of parasitic fungus.
That shell will block the attacks. Try getting behind it first.
Hey, who asked for your advice?
Upbeat.
The bridge looks treacherous.
Great.
Listen, this probably goes without saying, but...
Yes?
Be careful not to fall.
Right. This is disorienting.
Take you to the heart of the depot up ahead.
It's so close! In Palutena's name, I will eliminate the threat of the reset bomb!
Once and for all. it. Destroy the reset bomb pod to take down the entire depot.
Not a problem.
That's what you think. Guards! Wake up and report for duty!
And today I will go soaring through the sky. My enemies, I'll dish them up and us to fry. Gracious goddess of light, watches from up above. At dinner time, I always show the cook some love.
What are you singing?
Just this little victory song I made up. We stopped for 80. Now it's time to take down Hades.
Not quite. We saw to contend with our forces. Specifically, Arlon the Serene.
Oh, is he one of her commanders?
Yes, he has a weapon so lethal it makes reset bombs seem like firecrackers. Arlon's base is close by. You see the moon?
Yeah. It's really pretty tonight.
And what about that?
Like I said, they're pretty. Wait a sec. They're two moons?
They're like eyes watching you.
Aw, I wish they wouldn't. I get stage fright. Whoa, whoa, whoa! What kind of moon is that?
That's Arlong's lunar sanctum. Clearly, there's more to it than meets the eye.
Very cool. And dangerous! I take it back! It's not cool at all!
You're going in!
Me.
With all this firepower, Arlon must be preparing for a massive attack.
Why on earth would I be attacking? I'm far too busy defending, my dear.
Huh?
You must be Commander Arlon.
Pleasure to make your acquaintance, Lady Palatine. And yours too, young Master Fate. I have heard tales of your prowess from our Mistress Viridia.
Well, that's really nice of her.
She said I mustn't let your attacks spread chaos here, of all places. Before you cause the most unnatural harm, let us sit down for a chat.
I might consider it if you withdrew your forces and banded with us to face the Emperor Garden together.
Those decisions fall to the will of Mistress Green. Unfortunately, it's entirely out of my purview. I do hope you understand.
What's a purview? And why do you talk like that? My guys are supposed to be more like... Grawr! And I'm gonna kill you!
Ah, the young master is skilled in impressions, I see. Would you care to perform more?
That's all I've got.
Your fancy?
No.
Personally, I'm quite fond of them.
Right? Because I care so much.
Your concern is noted.
I was being sarcastic. I don't care at all.
Oh, yes. I almost forgot.
Forgot what?
To close the gates. And the gates go...
Gates! Cut it out!
The power of flight is dying out. We have to move. Find the breakable spots on the gates and shoot through. You can also break through with melee attacks. There's an entry point through a duct up ahead. It's tight, so watch out.
Ritzy.
It's like a whole other world. A classier world.
I'm deeply flattered by your gracious compliments.
Who knew the Lunar Sanctum would be so nice?
I could get used to a place like this.
Perhaps you could. But the Lunar Sanctum doesn't have room for any more guests.
Are my eyes playing tricks on me?
Arlon seems to have a penchant for visual trickery.
It's just a little something I whipped up to whet your appetite.
This is so annoying. Lady Palutena! Help me out here!
Deploying the Palutena Super Sensor.
I didn't know you had a super sensor.
I don't. You know I like to make stuff up.
Can't believe you're messing with me at a time like this.
Don't fret. You can use the green arrows to guide your way.
Now, how did you manage to place those here? Seems you've infiltrated the Lunar Sanctum's control core, Palutena. That leaves me relatively defenseless. I'd best rectify that post-haste. If you'll excuse me, I must go gird my loins for your tonight.
TMI! Nobody wants to hear about your loins! What do I do?
Look carefully at the mirror's image. You'll notice some inconsistency.
Seriously, that is the last time I want to hear from two.
Arline, did you call Batuu here?
I most certainly did.
He's not usually one to follow orders. How did you persuade him?
It's quite simple, actually. Just the mention of young Masterpiece's presence was enough to send his twin running here.
Batuu just isn't it.
Now what, fool?
Just wait till next time.
Destroy the Lunar Sanctum Control Center.
Myself in the golden melody of her sneeze.
That's why you should cover your sneezes.
I would never. A strong sneeze is the sign of a strong spirit.
This is so cool. It's like the surface of the moon.
Why was the Lunar Sanctum built anyway?
That information is highly confidential.
That only makes me more curious.
Curious or not, I took an oath of silence, and I intend to honor it.
Now, no need to get all bent out of shape.
After all, your name is Arlong the Serene.
I am well aware of my name. But back to the topic at hand. I cannot tell you the reasons why his sanctum was built. But I can say that it runs on my powers. Without me, it's just us. An empty shell. An orbiting house of cards.
Ooh, that sounds fancy.
I don't think we're getting the whole story here.
You are in no position to demand explanations. I am beholden only to Mistress Viridi, and you two are thorns in her side.
You've made your allegiances quite clear.
Then enough talking. Let's get back to fighting.
Thank you.
So this is an elevator?
That seems to be the case. Just shoot wildly, Pit. You do not want to get those clobblers mad. Try luring each one into a mine.
Good idea.
Pit's lucky to have such an excellent guard. Though we're on opposing sides, I must have been able to work out.
Thanks. It's just part of my job. Besides, Pit's the one doing all the heavy lifting, which is especially impressive for someone so small.
Arlon's quarters are directly ahead. Good luck.
Arlon!
Welcome. Please make yourself comfortable. It is my great honor to represent Mistress Veridi and the forces of nature.
I can't see!
Focus, Pit. Pay attention to where Arlon's attacks are coming from. After he attacks, shoot in that direction.
I say!
Good, just like that.
Very impressive, young Master Pit. It's time to achieve the true extent of my power.
I can finally catch my breath. Nothing.
I'm not so sure, but Veridi's forces are still a threat, so let's keep the heat on them.
Moving out! Ugh! Is the door busted?
The door is the least of our concerns. Hades has rejoined the fray.
Oh, no!
Oh, yes! Now we have both his and Faridi's forces wreaking havoc. The Underworld Army and forces of nature are out for blood, each other's and yours. On the Underworld side, Hades has put Thanatos back into play as commander.
Thanatos? He's still alive?
Apparently, and leading the forces of nature is Phosphora.
Phosphora?
Yes, you call?
So you're commanding the forces of nature.
We're in the middle of something here! Get this way!
So, Thanatos was resurrected as a glowworm?
I think the look he's going for is more glow dragon.
Wow, this is crazy!
It's the Underworld versus nature. Their commander's locked in fierce battle. I'm ready to pull you out of there if things get out of control.
I can't believe Thanatos is still alive.
And quite perky from the looks of things.
Well, that's only fair. I've been finished off a few times myself.
Thanatos, Pandora, Hydra. Hades revived them all from the old days. It must have taken some work to bring them back.
But this is Thanatos' third time around.
Thanatos is a special case.
You're telling me.
He is the god of death, after all. So he gets perks like angel powers, health insurance, and free soda.
Resurrected from the dead? That's some health insurance.
Whoa! I gotta admit, it's fast. Must be all that free soda.
Nothing if Phosphorus, no slouch.
Oh,
you
stop trying to butter up all the ladies? It's gross. There's nothing wrong with compliments.
Faridi! Where'd you come from?
But Commander Phosphora must also be respected for her power.
Anyway, Pit, just keep after Phosphora and Thanatos. It's great how they're wearing each other out like this. I mean, who knows? You may have to fight them both at the same time.
Well, we all know how that works.
Almost makes you take pity. Oh, pity. Danny Boo, are you okay?
Oh, yes! I'm not peachy!
He doesn't seem peachy.
That's because Phosphora combines the deep peachifying power and speed of lightning. Finishing blow!
Ah! Farewell, Prime!
Bravo! Bravo!
Oh me, oh my. Now what is it?
She really brought the thunder!
I said lightning.
Whatever. We'll just keep fighting without someone out there giving orders.
Are you saying it makes no difference whether your troops have a leader?
They're all idiots. Seriously. I don't even know if any of them have actual brains.
Where's Phosphora?
She must be recharging after the battle with Thanatos. Now's your chance. Let's hit her before she fully recovers.
Good idea.
We may not have the best dental plan, but justice is on our side.
Now it's our turn to bring the thunder.
Phosphora is in the middle of those clouds.
Persistent, aren't we?
I'm going to open up a path through these storm clouds. Stay sharp. Thundercloud Temple. It's been abandoned since ancient times.
Here already? I didn't even have a chance to take a shower.
Too bad!
I guess she's not completely spent after her battle with Thanatos.
It's just one fight after another. Today is not a day.
The fortune Mistress Faridi read didn't take her into picture either.
Wait. Faridi reads fortunes?
I wonder what other services she offers.
Anyway, it's on.
Looking forward to it. Sending you in. It looks like Phosphora is powering this place. We'll need to cut off the supply. Some of the pillars and walls are electrified. Don't get zapped!
Way easier if my sandals were rubber.
It's not my fault you conduct electricity so well.
We'll see who's laughing when I shut the power down.
Recharging at the temple's center.
Got it.
You'll need to move fast and get to her before she's done.
Absolutely, Lady Palutena.
Absolutely, Lady Palutena.
You're such a yes man, Pit. Good thing you're so cute.
You're not just making fun of me now, are you?
Oh, you're turning red. That's even cuter.
He embarrasses easily. Don't mind him.
Don't give it a second thought. Ma'am.
Uh-oh.
Did you just call me ma'am? Are you trying to start something?
You're right, I'm sorry. You're much too young to be called ma'am.
You know as well as I do the lifespan of gods. And how about you? What's your age?
I'll tell you mine if you tell me yours.
For the record, I don't mind being called sir.
Yes, well, as much as I'd like to continue this delightful chat, I know it's difficult when she's flirting with you, but remember that she's the enemy.
Right.
There seems to be an air vent in that platform. Turn on the air to help you up. To get a current started, move the spheres to the correct place. Good job, there's a weak breeze now. The air current is stronger. Use it to carry you up.
Thank you.
the movement of those electric currents.
I think it's probably fine to touch them. Seriously, they're perfectly safe.
Watch out when you see Phosphorus stop to gather energy. Once she has enough, she'll fire shots at the post that ricochet towards you.
Did you see that thunder?
No, because you can't see thunder.
Lovely little phosphor.
Smarm it up while you still can, Hades. We'll be after you soon enough.